There's no reason to raise a stink. The Cincinnati Zoo is back with Wild Wednesday and a friend who's often misunderstood. This is Amanda Chambers, and she's got a skunk. Yeah, a real life skunk. And she's here to explain some things we might not know about these animals that a lot of us have seen and smelled. And I'm guessing his smelling glands is removed, right, Amanda?
Yes, yes. That's a very, very simple procedure that happens when they're tiny little babies. But even if she did have her scent still, these skunks can only carry about a tablespoon of that liquid that can spray.
A tablespoon makes that big of a smell.
Yes, and so a tablespoon will hold 5 or 6 sprays, and then it takes like 10 days to fill back up. So spray as like a last defense. You'll see them stomping their feet and raising their tails and hissing, and that's your sign to get away if you don't want them to spray you.
How prevalent is it for people to see skunks around here?
Well, especially this time of year, it's baby season.
Okay.
So all the baby skunks are being born, so you might start seeing them out and about as the mom starts teaching them how to find their own food, which is lots of worms and grubs and berries and nuts and even things like snakes they'll eat.
So they're snakes.
Yeah, they're actually pretty good at keeping little things around your house that you don't want.
Yeah.
But they are adaptable. They're backyard animals. It's important to really watch out for backyard animals, not to get too close.
Mm-hmm.
I said, look for those
warning signs.
Because
they're still wild, even though they're cute.
They're very wild. But they also adapt to city life and suburban life because they're found all over the United States. So they might get into your garbage if you don't keep that secure. So if you do see skunks, I would suggest keeping your distance and then finding anything that might be keeping them around your house.
Are they out during the day a lot or mostly at night?
At night.
They're nocturnal. They
dusk and dawn is when they like to be out. So you shouldn't see them during the heat of the day.
Huh.
And then also you only see them in the warmer months. In the summer, they go dormant and spend a lot of time. They get really, really fat before the winter and spend time in their dens to stay warm and sleep through the winter while they can't find a lot of food.
Now, sometimes people have problems with them getting under their houses and kind of setting up camp down there, right?
And that happens during baby season, like I said, which is right now.
Right.
So if that happens, the biggest suggestion is, because a lot of times trappers, if you call someone, will not always know there's babies and they'll trap the mother and then the babies are left.
Aww.
So wait until baby season's over, let them all leave, and if they don't leave on their own, then you can try to relocate them.
Okay, but you should probably have somebody professional help you with that, right?
Yes, don't ever go and try to pick up a wild skunk on your own. I would never suggest that.
What's this skunk's name? I didn't ask you at the beginning.
Delilah,
that's, I think you did say that. Do you use her to help teach kids about skunks and mammals?
She is part of the ambassador animals at the zoo, so she does a lot of school programs and she goes out and about the zoo to educate people about backyard wildlife and all the important reasons that we should try to coexist with our backyard wildlife.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, Amanda. And thank you, Delilah. She's so cute. She's so friendly, isn't she? She's smelling a lot of stuff, too. Really neat. All right. Wild Wednesday. Go to the zoo. It's going to be a beautiful day for it, right, Tara?